has taken on the quest to find a cure for diabetes.
Her own mission.
Even with Mary's busy schedule, which we know she must coordinate, she still seems to find the time to help, and we really appreciate it. Share your unbelievable talents with us. Your unselfish nature is so apparent to us. Your family is such an important part of this community, and this year Barry and Linda have made it possible to honor their children, their fabulous family, as their very first honorees of the Young Society of Love and Hope. Please welcome Stephen and Gloria, Travis and Stacy, Michael, and their youngest, who has just turned 16, Allie Gibb. Ladies and gentlemen, I turn the microphone over to Barry Gibb.
Okay, everybody can hear me?
Hi everyone, it's our pleasure to be part of the Miami Beach community graduates. It's been a wonderful journey. Barry forgot his glasses, so he's wearing mine. There you go.
Alright. She'll come back. I'm gonna try and see this. I'd like to, if I may, quote, hang on, maybe I should just. I'd like to quote an article I found written in National Geographic in 1930. The article says, there are a million diabetics in the United States today. When diabetes attacks, it has come to stay. It rarely gives up. A diabetic has one of two choices, either to put up a cheerful continuous fight or weakly surrender. Halfway defense spells defeat, but a courageous and yielding fight is almost sure to win. Thousands of diabetics are not even aware of the fact that they are in danger because they have not had a physical examination, which would have revealed the presence of this old enemy of mankind. And because also, during most of its course, diabetes is painless. Of the 20,000 deaths caused by diabetes last year in the United States, 8,000 were of the acute type ending in coma. Yet a world-famous specialist says diabetic coma is always preventable and nearly always curable. Most of my patients have actually lived longer than would have been expected of them had they been normal, healthy people. That was 1930. 78 years later in the present, we are dealing with 15 million diabetes patients. 78 years later. So the question today is, have we made any great progress in curing this terrible disease? And the evidence shows that it is an uphill, never-ending battle with something that isn't truly even growing. And so it takes a Sonia Zuckerman, and it takes a Sandy Leeling, And it takes a Barbara Singer, and it takes a Nero Lowe, and it takes a Kathy Simkins, and it takes my beautiful wife Linda, and it takes people like the Diabetes Research Institute, and all of those involved in it to fight this battle. Everybody here tonight is part of the force that will defeat this disease. Linda and myself and our children, whom you have so graciously honored tonight, pledge to be never-ending little cogs in this giant wheel. Thank you all for listening. That's enough for me.